Because there's something in you.
Stay back! Stop!
What on earth have you been doing?
If you seek fair prices for quality work, you have come to the right.
Bring me your sick and wounded.
Here come John.
I've many other items.
You want it?
Perhaps another time.
Ciao.
Liar! People, if you have any...
I distilled an elixir of lead.
Another time.
What the hell? What the
hell? Anywhere!
Go. In it!
No!
Stay back!
Oh, God!
What the?
Leonardo.
Ezio, so good to see you. How can I help you?
Ha ha! You found another one! How exciting!
I see. If I just rearrange these letters... Here, it's done.
Salute, bello mio. Come stai? You back to see me already?
Desolato, mia cara. But I am not here to play. I must speak with Antonio. It's urgent.
Antonio! Ezio's here!
Ezio, is everything all right?
Carlo Grimaldi and the Barbarigo are in league with the one they call the Spaniard. They're going to murder the Doge and replace him with one of their own.
they will have all of Venezia, her entire fleet, in their grasp.
And they call me a criminal.
Then you'll help me.
You have me on your side, brother. And the support of all my men.
And women.
Grazie, amici.
But, Ezio, I must warn you. It's not going to be so easy this time. Palazzo Ducale is the most heavily guarded building in Venezia.
Nothing is impenetrable.
This is why we like you, Ezio.
Come, let's go take a look. We'll come up with a plan. Business with the Doge. Terrible. Though, treachery like this no longer surprises me. When I was a child, we were taught that the nobles were just and kind. I believed it. Though my father was only a cobbler, and my mother a scullery maid, I aspired to be much more. I studied hard. I persevered. But the nobles would never have me. If you are not born one of them, acceptance is impossible. So I ask you, Ezio, who are the true nobles of Venezia? Men like Carlo Grimaldi and Marco Barbarigo. No! I say we are the thieves and mercenary and whores. While we work to save this city and its people, the nobles seek to make it their plaything.
Nothing for you here, Cafone.
We need to scout the palazzo carefully. See it from every angle. We just might find a way in. I know of a tall campanile behind the palazzo. Or we might find a way to climb the back of the basilica. Do you have any ideas?
I assume the front door is out.
Va bene. We'll try the front door as well, Saputello.
So, what do you think?
We're not getting in this way. They'll have time to murder the Doge before we're able to get through all these guards. Look at that. Archers everywhere.
And the walls are impossible to climb on this side.
Well, aren't you a funny monkey?
Application as your Carpaccio is...
healing services for all the gods' flock.
Bene, we're in luck. Looks like there's a perfect path up the scaffolding to the roof of the basilica. Shall we? Ezio, look! Isn't that him? Grimaldi!
Don't you understand what I'm offering you, Signore? Listen to me, please. Or this will be your last chance.
How dare you!
I'm sorry. Mi dispiace. I meant nothing by it. I'm only looking out for your safety.
We're running out of time. There's no way through this fence, and there are guards everywhere. Diavolo!
Qui. Let's do it.
It's impossible. There's no way in or out for men. Only birds.
Yes. Birds.
Where are you going now?
To see my friend Leonardo.
Carlo Grimaldi. Emerging from his palace in Monaco with a craving for political power, Carlo quickly became a key guest at the tables of Venetian nobility, while his reputation for discretion earned him entrance into the back rooms. Here's how the old bastard ended up in the Council of Ten. While visiting the head of the council, Ignacio Contarini, Carlo ran into Ignacio's daughter. Desperate for help and aware of Carlo's trustworthy reputation, she confided in him. Her father had arranged her marriage, but she wanted to run away with the son of one of the servants. They'd been in love since they were children, and they planned to start a new life in Milan, where they could be free of her father. Carlo suggested immediate action, an escape by ship that night. The two lovers followed his instructions, and as they climbed the gangplank, they were free. That is, until Ignacio appeared on deck. Carlo was rewarded for his loyalty to the Contarini family. While true love, well, see for yourself.
Has he lost his mind?
The disputed lands to the south are to be excluded from all mercantile enterprise. However,
away from me, Phil! Guards! Take it all! Let me live!
Please don't kill me, Signora! I'll give you all I have!
Take it all! Let me...
I should have stayed at home!
This is none of my affair!
Getting out of here. This is too much.
There he is, Laggiù!
Basta! Figlio Vulcani!
No one is safe anymore. They'll be after me next.
I didn't mean any harm.
My fault. Scusate.
No, stay back. No.
I need your help, Leonardo. Does it work?
What? What are you asking?
Does it work, Leonardo? Can it really fly?
I don't know. It's only a prototype, an idea. It's not ready yet.
Have you tried it?
No, it's too dangerous. To test it, you'd have to leap off a tower. Who would be mad enough to do a thing like that?
Leonardo, I think you just found your madman. So, how does she work?
Have you ever watched a bird in flight? It's not about being lighter than air. It's about grace and balance. You must use your body's own weight to control your elevation and direction. Good luck, Ezio.
This is ridiculous! The Palazzo's too far away! Diavolo, I give up! I'm gonna end up killing myself before I ever kill an...
I can't believe it! It worked! It really worked! You flew, Ezio! You flew!
See, but not very far.
Well, what were you expecting? The machine wasn't designed for distance. All right, look, let me go over my plans here. Maybe I can find some way to extend the duration of the flight.
Ezio! My men tell me Carlo has the poison. We must hurry.
Antonio, this is Leonardo, the master inventor who built this pezzo di merda.
Hey, it's not the machine's fault. It's mine. I checked and rechecked my blueprints. It's just impossible. I don't know how to extend the flight. Da, che idea del cazzo! Eureka! Of course! Genio!
What is he doing now?
It rises. It needs fire. Heated air under its wings will lift the machine.
Leonardo, what good is one fire going to do?
Not one fire, Ezio. A dozen, built all across the city. Enough to carry you from here all the way to the Palazzo Ducale.
How? Ah, capisco. My men could do that, but you are forgetting about the guards.
Don't worry. I will take care of them.
I'll give the order to have my men move in behind you, and hold the locations. They'll light them all up the second the sun goes down over San Marco.
Remember, you don't want to push your luck with the gods, boy.
I reach a good fortune, fight!
Come again.
do you, Pazu? Get him! There!
Is going to murder me if I miss dinner again.
Hey, Katie Frege, just go. It's not like we're guarding the Doge.
What the hell are we guarding anyway?
A shipment from China. Some kind of colored powder they brought over for a big party. Really expensive, you ask me. Leave. The way these nobles spend their money.
I see him!
Ah!
Done what I could. Perhaps you should avoid the deal that broke
me. Air strikes! About me.
Glad to be of service.
Accept my apologies, good sir.
He will break his
neck. Shadows are his
eyes. You stay at home.
Perhaps I should stay.
I see it is in you.
Don't go bothering.
It's time.
You did it. It's beautiful.
See. Now let's hope your idea works, because we're nearly out of time.
Listen close, Ezio. You're going to want to fly from fire to fire. The heat of each one you pass over should lift you back up in the air again.
Bene.
Careful, though. There's archers out on the roofs tonight. Avoid those arrows, or it will be a short trip.
I wish there was some way I could use my sword while flying these things.
Well, you do have your feet free. If you get close enough without taking an arrow in the head, maybe you could kick them off the building.
Nice.
It's now or never, amigo mio.
Makose! Shoot! Shoot a flying demon!
What's that?
Don't worry. Probably just kids with firecrackers. Come, it's your move.
Get down, or I'll throw you down.
Don't drink that!
You are too late. The Doge is dead.
What? Carlo?
Apologies, Signore. But you should have listened to me when you had the chance. Seems you have failed, assassin.
Forgive me, Signore. I tried.
Why? What was it all for?
Assassin! No! Assassino! He's killed the Doge! The Doge is dead!
It takes one assassin to kill another, it seems.
We kill thinking it's best for us. Do we not, Messer Ezio?
I do this not for myself.
Compio questo sacrificio per il bene superiore. Requiescat in pace.
You killed me? You killed me!
Get the bastard!
Alert!
shall make...
Ciao, signore.
E mention me to your amici.
The hand that deals in death so far, that one is...
What you need, somewhere in the back, perhaps.
Coraggio, amico. I'm really with you every step of the way.
There is something moving over there in that haystack.
Sit back down. We're in the middle of playing a tarot game.
No. This time I saw something. I know it.
That's what you say every time. You were right. There was something in the haystack, you femminucha.
I'm tired of your jokes. This isn't funny. I could have been killed.
By that?
You don't take our work seriously. One misstep. One time you turn your back in the wrong direction, and you're dead.
Because of rats.
I'm not going to explain myself to you anymore.
Please, don't stop. This is so entertaining.
let me be.
Please, come back.
Leave me alone!
Run faster!
Leave me alone!
Run faster!
Leave me alone! Leave me alone!
Run faster! Run faster!
Leave me alone!
Run faster!
Leave me alone!
Run faster!
Thank you. Mercy, take my money!
Here. Get down, Stronzo!
of Venezia have been revised. These have been posted as amendments to the law.
Only the height of the smithy arts are available here. If you've no stomach for luxury,
somewhere on it.
That's a man, not like Arrigo.
As you wish, perhaps another day.
A smart choice. Ciao for now.
Just count it again.
Thank you.
Thank you, Altair, for this great gift. May it shield me from my enemies.
Come, don't be shy.